And then I would cut holes in the container. Well, more like skylights, so light would come in, but not directly. And you could hear the ocean and smell it, but you wouldn't be able to see it. What you would see are my paintings.
The paintings about the destruction of the environment.
Exactly. You've seen them.
Yeah. They're really heavy. Scary, actually.
That's the point. What we are doing to the world is scary. So I'm going to get people so close to the ocean, you know? So close that they're almost experiencing it. It'll be like another nice day out at the beach, but then BAM! They're seeing my paintings. I think it'll really elicit a nice sense of urgency, you know?
Yeah, I can see that. Huh. I always told you it was a really good idea. So when are you gonna do it?
Well, I still feel like I need more paintings.
You're talking about the destruction of the environment thing? Don't you have like 20 of that series already?
I know, but now I'm thinking I want to like completely fill the space. Like, no bit of the container wall will be showing at all.
But I thought part of the whole thing was the container as a signifier of industrialization and consumerism. And the giant ships polluting the water and endangering the whales and shit.
Well, I'm still working things out.
Hey guys, guess who's back in town this weekend?
Shelby!
Whoa! I haven't seen Shelby like in 5 years or something.
Yeah, I think we're still friends on Facebook. Still. But I don't remember the last time I talked to her. What is she doing back?
She's doing a book signing at Tatter Parks.
What? Let me see that.
Shelby Lyons, who's arguably the city's best writer in over a generation, returns to her hometown to share her latest work with local fans. 1,500 Miles is Ms. Lyons' third volume in a trilogy now being touted as being on par with Updike's Rabbit series.
Jealous much?
Fuck you! I'm glad she's doing so well. I'll probably go over for the signing. It'll be nice to see her.
Yeah, that's probably just because you want the rights so you can finally have something good to pitch into that publishing company you say is so very interested in you.
Jeez, Jordan, why do you have to be such a bitch?
Hey!
Hey.
Guys. Hey. Check out this new design for the t-shirts for the new band.
I can't say I really like the brown and green one at all.
It's the best one.
I like the brown and green one.
See? Guys, Shelby likes it too. Oh no, the bassist and the drummer, they left for LA. But me and the guitar is helping me band now. It's called Aspira. We're still looking for a drummer, though. We have some auditions set up already, though. In fact, I think there's one tonight, so I don't think I can make your reading.
Oh, I mean, that's okay. It's no big deal, really. I'm just glad I get to see you. Like, hey, Jordan, what have you been up to? I saw a couple of your essays online, didn't I?
Yeah.
Do you have enough yet for a whole collection? I mean, I always love the theme of them connecting the stories to different coffee drinks. That would be so hip right now. This is such a coffee culture.
Yeah. Well, you know, I'm actually sort of over the coffee theme idea. It seems a bit trivial now. I want to think pieces. I have more important things to write about than small town characters. This would be what type of latte they order.
Yeah. Well, of course, but, and listen. Once you get some stuff pulled together, here is the info for my publicist. I've already talked to you, I've talked to her about you, and she'd be happy to help. Oh, hey, Chloe, how did your Destruction of the Earth exhibit go in? I am so sorry I missed it.
No, you didn't.
What?
It hasn't happened yet.
I'm still figuring out exactly how I want to do things.
Man, I thought you had it all figured out when I left. You just ordered a shipping container.
There are just more elements to consider than I first thought.
Well, I don't know what you mean. I mean, I thought it was an awesome idea. I don't know what else you have to figure out.
Can you just stop it? Can you just stop being so condescending? Just because you've been swatted at a time with your problems, it doesn't mean you can just sit there and judge us on what we have been doing or not been doing.
What are you talking about?
Our work is deadly important to us. It matters to us. We're not just doing it for some million-dollar book deal or bombing write-ups by big-city critics. It comes from the heart. And so if it takes a little bit more time than it takes for you to become the next update, so be it. And anyway, you know your work isn't really that good. If there's any comparison to Updike, it's that your latest work is completely derivative of Rap Remember. And so that's why I am so shocked that you're actually here, because I know you know that, and I know that you know we know that. God.
You know what? Man, you're right. I actually came here hoping I wouldn't see any of you. I came here hoping that you guys wouldn't be here. And do you want to know why? Because I was hoping that somehow you have gotten your shit together enough to pull through on one of your ideas. That you'd be on tour with your band, that you'd have a production company for your short film, that you would have moved on to bring awareness to some other topic, like, I don't know, drug abuse or human trafficking or the proliferation of cat memes. And you, I wouldn't have to give you my editor's number because you'd already have one of your own. Man, I can't believe you are all still here! Exactly how I left you 7 years ago! Still sitting on this fucking couch! You know, when I first went to the city and I told people where I was from, they had all heard of this place. I couldn't believe it. I mean, this is such a small, stupid town, but no. We have quite the reputation. Do you want to know what they call us? The Graveyard of Ambition. I mean, I laughed at them. I said, look at me. I'm here. I'm alive. I'm doing my thing. And I've got these friends, these amazing artists, and they are all doing these amazing things. I thought that name was bullshit.
She really feels.
Yeah. She, like, pities us. That's
done waiting now.
I thought you were auditioning a drummer anyway.
I just said that.
I need a drink. Shots?
Definitely.
Kryptonite cow.